So now let's cross over to France to meet the current president of the Paris Peace Forum and former Director General of the World Trade Organization, Mr. Pascal Lamy. So, Mr. Lamy, thank you very much for being here with us.
My pleasure.
So it's already pretty clear that Donald Trump is a winner regardless of the outcome. So after 4 years, can you say that his protectionism vision of trade and economic policies has finally won over? Is Trumpism here to stay?
Well, I think whatever opinion we have of the man, and we may have our own opinions, it's clear that he has support from a large part of US public opinion. I'm not sure his trade policy is the result of that. He wanted to shrink the US trade deficit. He has increased the US trade deficit. So it's all politics, narrative, not real economics, unfortunately, in my view.
But however, during these years, we've seen major shifts, including the rise of China as the main geopolitical and technological rival of the United States, and the further deepening of income inequality at home and abroad, which is getting even deeper because of the COVID crisis. So how realistic is it to expect from the next president to focus on restoring multilateralism on trade? Is this so-called buying American supported going to be supported in any case?
US considers China is a threat. China considers US is a threat. This will have geopolitical and trade consequences, but this does not stem from an a priori protectionist position. I think if Biden was to be the president of the US, Biden would also believe that China is a threat to the US, but he would handle China differently. Not by arm twisting, more by negotiations.
And would all these developments in the United States lead Europe to be a more unified actor globally, or this unity might be jeopardized because all the internal divisions that we already see on the other side of the Atlantic?
I think if I'm right, that the US-China rivalry is the real game in geopolitical terms, for the 20 years to come, EU needs to unite in order to reduce its vulnerability either to China or to the US. And there is no other way to reduce EU vulnerabilities than more European unity. We all know it's difficult, we all know it's complex, but in a sense, US, Russia, Turkey, China tell us the way to go. If we want to defend both our interests and values on the international scene, we need to integrate further. And I think this is a necessity which little by little will appear if it hasn't been the case yet.
So I guess what you are saying is that it's a different world that we are waking up after this election. So Mr. Lamy, thank you very much for being with us here on Euronews.
My pleasure.